finally putting it all together as Miles Bridges misses underneath. Here's Dougie McBuckets, top of the circle. Week and a half of the season, but they lost their last five games. Really stumbled to that finish line as McDermott knocks in another three.
For the Pacers.
Here comes Sabonis, puts it on the deck, lays it up and gets a friendly little bounce.
Offensively, able to knock down that triple.
Monk, who's had a career year in terms of his numbers. What a shot, Brogdon! Up over the shoulder and a chance at three for Indiana.
Still playing unselfishly. Nice cut there, able to get that inside position. Just don't get the sense that the sense of urgency you expect to have in an elimination game has been on display here from Charlotte as they continue to get sliced up.
And this now is their largest lead of the night.
And that's the advantage of having a big man who can pass the basketball. Just a great job again at the start of the third quarter. There's no way I could believe that.
Little pick and roll action, and finally Sabonis able to get to the bottom of the cup
in this game. And you can see a nice find there from Hop.
First ever NBA play-in tournament. Ball! Oh, that would have been thunderous. In command with a 25-point lead. Here's Sabonis, backs down against Washington, a little lean-in step back. And he gets the friendly bounce again.
And the other thing they did really well with him, they were terrific in crunch time. And Sabonis, strong move there for the finish.
Right, it seems like he can say that for just about everyone who's put the uniform on for Indiana. Here's Brissett again from deep. It's target practice.
Technical foul issued to Charlotte number four, Devontae Graham.
They have just dug themselves a hole from which I'm not sure you can recover.
A team that overachieved for so much this season. Sabonis for that eighth and final spot over the final couple of weeks of the season, but they lost their last five games and put them in this spot tonight.
We've seen stranger things happen, but they're going to have to string some stops together here this last 3 minutes.
Sabonis starting to get comfortable. Sabonis takes it back. He's just so gifted with the basketball in his hands.
Domantas, thanks a lot for joining us. We appreciate it.
Yeah, of course. Thanks for having me.
So, look, I know the diplomatic answer is always, well, we'll play who's ever in front of us. Yeah. But when you consider Washington swept you and Westbrook had triple-doubles in all three games, Beal had a 50-point game, Boston took two out of three, is there a preferable matchup? Would you rather play the Celtics than the Wizards?
At the end of the day, not really. I feel like we've been playing better this month as a team. You know, the ball's been moving. Everybody's feeling it. So, to be honest, it just depends on us and how strong we come out the next game.
Domantas, Shaq here. You've been playing fabulous all year. Tough first half. You went 1-for-8. Picked up a little bit second half. With all the injuries to your team, do you think you need to score a little bit more? You know, be more aggressive when it comes to scoring?
Yeah, of course. Sometimes the defenses are throwing different things at me, and I'm just trying to get my guys open for open looks, you know. And sometimes if they back off, that's where I got to be more aggressive and put some of the scoring on my shoulders.
You know, Domantas, you guys had an interesting year. You kind of just been up and down all year. Do you think now you're starting to get a couple guys healthy, your confidence is sky high going into the next game?
Yeah, I feel like everybody's confidence is the highest it's been all year. You know, obviously we wish it was before, but you know, this is the perfect timing for us. You know, and it's one game. You know, anything can happen. So we're just gonna come out, keep playing team ball, and hopefully get this win.
Domantas, you know, Charles always says to me that you are not an all-star, but a superstar. And honestly, tonight is the night I agree with him, because I always feel a superstar affects the game more than just one way. And when you weren't scoring, you get 21 rebounds, you still have 9 assists. So we know those three categories, but also your leadership and defense were really impressive tonight. So 5 ways, you dominate the game in 4 of the 5 categories, even though you didn't score. So tonight, I will agree with you, Chuck. This man is a true superstar. That's just a commentary to me, and I agree with you, Chuck. Yep.
Thanks, guys. You know, I'm just trying to come out and affect the game in different ways, you know, and help my teammates out.
Last thing for me, Domantas, just tell me what it meant to have Malcolm Brogdon back in there on the same night that you learned Caris LeVert is going to be out for a while with the health and safety protocol.
Yeah, it's tough. I woke up from my nap and I saw my phone blowing up. Everyone's like, what's wrong with Caris? I'm like, what happened? So, you know, it definitely sucks, you know, losing him. But Malcolm came right in time. You know, he's one of the leaders of this team. And, you know, everybody looks up to him. So having him in there really gave us an energy boost.
144-117, energy boost indeed. Nice going, Domantas, and good luck in the next game as you continue to try to get into the playoffs here.
Thank you, guys. Thanks for having me.